Okay, we're starting day three of corn harvest. I just put 15 gallons of gas in the tank and just kind of looking stuff over. Our deer hunters, one of them's out this morning, so hopefully he gets a good good sized deer. And I noticed that my head drifted a little bit last night, so I'm gonna raise the header up first before I do any greasing. But before we can do that, we gotta start the combine. So. Dad said he just, well, Dad just hauled the first load of corn this morning from running last night, and it was 142 bushels, so that's pretty sweet. And then he's hauling the second load up now, and then I'll have two empty wagons to fill once we get going here. Already checked the oil, it's looking good. I had tightened all the oil pan bolts up the other day, that helped a lot. This going. Don't take very long for that oil pressure to get up. I like that. I'm running some Lucas engine stop leak or something in this to help deal with the oil consumption, and it really makes a difference. I need to clean off my windshield. Everything's got a heavy dew on it. Shut it off. I got the driving toolbox today. She sounds pretty good though this morning, so that's. Ran really good last night. I know I'm gonna have a bunch of ears I need to pick up off the ground, because I planted this. I should have planted more straight, less curves, but I was pretty happy with how it did. This is some of the last corn I ran last night, and she's still doing a good job. I don't think we're losing more than a bushel or so. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So maybe 2 bushel. Maybe I'll slow her down a little bit. Some of that is off the head. There isn't anything I can do about that. But I switched running 2 rows at a time, and that helps out a lot. I think I'm running more consistently. The corn is looking great. It's a beautiful morning. It's sunrise here. These ears are just barely hanging on, but there's some nice looking corn. And of course we got, so it's strange. See, like the birds got a hold of this one, but we'll do our best and try to get it all in before the animals eat it. There's the view of the combine. It's warming up. I got the truck and the gravity wagon back. So we'll, once I get everything greased, I'll get back with you guys. Cool. So I just wanted to grease these rollers down here. They have a circ at the end of the snap roller that is a good one to hit. The ground is pretty moist this morning. Everything's got a layer of dew on it. Luckily Dad's grease gun was in the shop, which is insulated, so I didn't have to wait for the grease to warm up to put that in. Okay, so I haven't even ran corn yet. It's almost 11 o'clock. Just got back from getting parts. I noticed that this line that was going into this valve was leaking real bad. So we ran in and got the line. I'm gonna go ahead and install that right now. This is the fitting we just replaced, or the hose. I don't see anything coming out of it. And then this one here looks to be leak free, so I'm gonna go ahead and put this mount this back up on this steel bracket here and we'll be in good shape. That wasn't a bad fix. I get pretty impatient when I take days off from work. I want to get work done like this, but just gotta stay patient and keep working at it. Have faith that it'll all get done. Well, best part about replacing the hydraulic lines is you're going to be losing less fluid, so going to cost you that much less money to run it. Yeah, I think those are good to go. So I think I'm going to close this up, get finished greasing stuff, and I guess I'll get out in the field after lunch here. Okay, well, after a morning of fixing stuff and greasing and doing all that kind of stuff, we're finally ready to get some corn ran. It's about 12:30. Probably won't need my coat in here, but I figured I'd grab it just in case. Would like the gloves though. What else I got in here? Oh, I got my temperature sensor too for checking bearings later on. Everything seemed to run really good last night, so there's no real, not too worried today. Since we hopefully got the breakdowns out of the way for the morning, for the day, we'll hopefully be able to run some corn now. I'm sure everyone's getting tired of watching me fix stuff. Beautiful sunny day here. Let's turn the screen on. We got a nice clear view behind us. I think I'm gonna set you guys on we'll set you inside the truck now. Thank you. Okay, so we have breakdown number two today. The filter that's in the carburetor, it got plugged up, and so did the inline filter. So we swapped out the inline filter and the carburetor filter, and I'm gonna go see if this thing is gonna work. I sure hope so. Fingers crossed. Well, I just topped off the second wagon here and it's 4:30, so they're supposed to stay open until 6 if I remember right. So I'm gonna haul at least one of these loads up the elevator right now, and then that'll give me one more wagon. Combine needs to cool down anyways. So I'm gonna run one of these up. Oh boy, it's warm in here. Let it not back up too much. Looks like I parked a 5-wheeler behind the leg. Alright, we'll be back in a little bit. There's the WD. All right, well, another day ends out in the field. Got all three hopper wagons filled up. And so far so good. The bearing seems to be working out real good, staying cool. Engine staying cool. So everything seems to be working okay. So I think I'm gonna go inside, get cleaned up, and get some rest. It was definitely a trying day, so very happy, very thankful that I'm able to do this, and God keeps giving me the opportunity, me and my family, to continue the farm. So that's all for tonight. We'll continue videoing tomorrow. And hopefully just be a nice, smooth day. All right, thanks. Y'all have a good evening. God bless.